So hello everyone, welcome to Arbiter. So guys, if you guys are preparing for the upcoming RBI examination, one thing that will be coming into your mind is, what about finance current affairs? Do we actually need to prepare finance current affairs? Can we skip finance current affairs? If we have to cover finance current affairs, what does actually finance current affairs consist of? Okay, so here you have seen banking and finance current affairs, which means all the banking news is part of finance current affairs, or all the finance current affairs are part of banking news that we are reading. So guys, there is a difference in that, and in today's video, I will be giving you each and every important point that will be there in your mind about the finance current affairs. We will discuss each and every point, and I hope by the end of the video you will be clear that if you are preparing finance current affairs, what needs to be prepared, how many months of finance current affairs needs to be prepared, and what are the important dimensions of finance current affairs you should always keep in your mind when you are preparing for the examination. But before that guys, I just wanted to give you a glimpse of this comprehensive guidebook that we have prepared for you. So in this guidebook, guys, we have tried a lot so that it can save your time, or it will really, really save your time, I can say. Because it consists of all the important informations that you need to know. First of all, the role of RBI has been explained here. Along with that, we have defined you the hierarchical structure that is there in the RBI examination. After that, the most important thing for generally for which we keep on searching a lot, or काफी ज्यादा time students का waste हो जाता है, like things like to know about the recruitment cycle, the eligibility criteria, the cutoffs, as well as the syllabus, especially for the phase 1 examination, which generally students have a query कि क्या क्या phase 1 में पढ़ना है, किस किस section में, each and everything has been defined here. Along with that guys, the resource list has also been mentioned here, not just for the phase 1 examination, but also for the phase 1, phase 2, and even for the interview stage also. And at the end guys, we are guiding you here along with this guidebook also, by providing you a 6-step domination formula with which you could prepare your, with which you could strategize your preparation for the upcoming RBI examination. One thing very, very important guys, this is absolutely free. You just have to invest 1 second of yours. There's a link given below in the description below of this video. Click on that link and this guidebook will be yours. Now, first of all, the first question that I was asking you is, why finance current affairs? For that, we need to understand the weightage of finance current affairs in your examination. So if I talk about this year's examination, total 66 questions were there that were there in your phase 1 examination from current affairs. Out of these 66 questions, guys, there are 13 questions which were directly being handled from banking and finance current affairs, if we can shortlist them. Now, in these 13 current affairs, the questions that have been asked, I will be explaining about that also. But along with that, if I talk about, there are 3 questions which were, from which static questions were being asked, but they are again being picked from your current affairs. For example, DICGC. DICGC, they have asked a question, okay, which can again, because DICGC was seen in news a lot of time in RBI, that's why they have handpicked a question from DICGC. Again, means finance current affairs important hai, because directly nahi, indirectly bhi questions jo hai, aapke examination mein puche ja rahe hai from the finance current affairs. Then, if I talk about the other important things like IBPI, we can talk about this also, corporate resolution, CSR ka part, IBPI, that can also be part of finance current affairs indirectly. So again, the question has been asked on this specific line also. And if I talk about phase 2, so yes, in phase 2, many students have a doubt that finance current affairs does not come. But guys, if I talk about in management, there was no current affairs based question. But out of the 19 questions, 19 marks of paper that was from finance, 5 marks of questions in the objective paper were from current affairs, which means this can also help you. Okay, it's not a major part, but still it can help you. But now guys, we have a descriptive paper also in your examination. And if I talk about the question that has been asked is long-term repo operations. What is long-term repo operation? They have asked your question in the descriptive of finance. And if I talk about this descriptive paper, if you have to write a very good answer for this, you need to be very, very thorough about current affairs. ठीक है, लॉन्ग टर्म रेपो ऑपरेशन बहुत ज्यादा न्यूज में आता है, आरबीआई के अंदर बहुत ज्यादा न्यूज में भी आ रहा था. सो विच मीन्स डायरेक्टली नहीं, बट इनडायरेक्टली द थिंग्स दैट आर सीन इन न्यूज कैन प्ले अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन द एग्जामिनेशन. ठीक है, तो ये चीज आपको हमेशा याद रखनी है कि इन फाइनेंस करंट अफेयर्स, यस यू माइट बी सीइंग हियर दैट द नंबर ऑफ करंट अफेयर्स दैट क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी लेस, बट इनडायरेक्टली ऑल्सो गाइस दे कैन प्ले अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन द एग्जामिनेशन. Now the second thing, we have understood that why finance core interface is important. We have understood the weightage of that. But now is the important thing, how to prepare finance core interface, because the most common question that will be coming into our mind is, what actually is finance current affairs consist of? Because you have read a lot of, you are reading a lot of current affairs. But if I tell you to segregate finance current affairs, how you will do that? Let's come to the answer of that. So guys, if I talk about overall bank and finance current affairs, the basic news that you will be reading, TKG, and how you have to read it. First of all, if I talk about finance current affairs majorly, the most important thing here is RBI notifications or RBI press release. Because it is an examination of RBI, so direct questions aapko RBI notification se puche ja rahi hain. Along with that, there are some topics which are important for phase 1 and have a weightage in phase 2 also. For example, banking reforms or committees. So if some major banking reform has taken place, it has done by RBI. So this is important for the examination, so which means these are again important for the examination. Theek hai ji? Along with that, बैंक मर्जर्स, तो बैंकिंग मर्जर्स क्या है, ये कुछ कॉमन न्यूज़ है जो आपकी फेस वन में रेलेवेंट है, जो आप बैंकिंग करंट अफेयर्स पढ़ते हो, ठीक है, इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ दैट. देन बैंकिंग कमिटीज, एसबीआई फॉर्म द कमिटी और सम अदर वंस हैज फॉर्म द कमिटी, दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. बट इफ इट इज अ मेजर कमिटी, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आरबीआई हैज क्रिएटेड अ कमिटी एंड इट हैज रिलीज इट्स रिपोर्ट, दैट कमिटी इटसेल्फ, दैट कमिटीज रिपोर्ट विल बिकम अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन एंड इट कैन रियली रियली हेल्प यू इन द इंटरव्यू स्टेज ऑल्सो. सो दैट्स हाउ बैंकिंग कमिटीज प्ले एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन द एग्जामिनेशन. एंड लास्ट द इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट आई विल से इज जनरल फाइनेंस करंट अफेयर्स रिलेटेड टू सिलेबस, एंड दिस इज द थिंग दैट हैज बीन क्लियरली डिफाइंड इन अवर आरबीआई नोटिफिकेशन, इज द सिलेबस ऑफ आरबीआई. इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द टॉपिक्स दैट आई वाज डिस्कसिंग विद यू, हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं कि मेमोरेंडम ऑफ कंपनीज एक्ट पे क्वेश्चन पूछा गया, व्हाई इट माइट हैव बीन आस्क्ड, ठीक है जी. कॉर्पोरेट गवर्नेंस, प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी मार्केट, क्वेश्चन हैव बीन आस्क्ड, ठीक है जी. नाउ व्हाई आरबीआई नोटिफिकेशंस, आरबीआई एंड इट्स फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन, Reserve Bank of India function and conduct of monetary policy. These are two points which are directly related to RBI, and these are being explained in वहाँ पे कहाँ पे explained होते हैं? These are being explained in your RBI notification. And if I give you an example, so look at the recent examination that have taken place. First exchange traded Bharat bond has been launched by which of the following company? Asked from financial market, primary and secondary market. General finance current affairs question पूछा गया. Which of the following is not among the baseline assumptions? ठीक है, monetary policy committee. If I talk about from syllabus, Reserve Bank of India and financial institutions, or if I talk about RBI and its functions and conduct of monetary policy clearly defined in our syllabus. Question being asked from RBI notifications. Then India has recently become the only country to adopt the T+1 settlement. Again, the question will be asked from financial markets, general finance, current affairs. So this is how the finance current affairs is important for the examination and how you could segregate the normal current affairs with finance current affairs. Now, the important question is how many months of current affairs do we need to prepare for finance? Because yes, we are seeing that it is a really, itna zyada marks nahi hai, but phir bhi kitna padna hai, let's talk on that. Okay, so if I talk about the phase 1 examination, guys, so total 18 questions were there from bank and finance, including current plus static. I have talked about current questions, that were 13 questions were directly questions, but 5 questions though aapke static mein the, wo bhi current se hi derived the, that were also being derived from current affairs. And out of these questions, 16 questions were the questions that have been asked from the past 5 months. So which means if you are starting preparing for the finance current affairs, last 5 months is the key here, and from this past 5 months, last 3 months is the key here. And if I talk about from where to calculate this past 5 months, 1 week before the examination you have to calculate the days for 5 months, beyond that is important for phase 1. And if I talk about phase 2, guys, yahan pe questions bahut kam the, there are only 5 questions. But here, if I talk about the coverage till 8 months is important. Okay, so coverage till 8 months is important for the examination for phase 2. Now, if I talk about the most important thing, if you are preparing for finance, because the important is what to read here. So, what to read, okay, ji? But before that, if I just give you an example. Unicorn pe question aaya tha, 6th of May, okay, ji, kitne months important hai? Monetary Policy Committee, I have just discussed you, it was released in the month of April. Examination for phase 1 was in May and question was asked from the month of April. Now, if I talk about important sources here, so guys, these are the important sources which you could refer, because RBI website is very, very important, which consists of RBI notifications, RBI press releases that you can read. Along with that, guys, the important meme that have been highlighted in your syllabus are the newspapers of Live Mint and Hindu Business Line. They have been defined in the RBI notification only. So that's why these two newspapers again play a very, very important role in your examination if you are preparing for the finance current affairs. So again, if I give you an example here, Live Mint हमने अभी देखा और हमने Monetary Policy Committee का भी question अभी देखा that I've just shown you. Now the important thing is, guys, how much time we need to devote and how we are helping you. First and foremost thing is, if you are preparing your own notes, so two things that you need to work on is analyze the PYQs and read the important points that are relevant for the examination for which syllabus is important. Okay, so how we are helping you, okay ji? So guys, what we have done is, we have segregated even your banking and finance current affairs in such a way so that your proper preparation for phase 1 and phase 2 can take place. If I give you an example, in this notification, in this current time magazine that we are providing you, you can see finance current affairs. But in this magazine, in the GS section, we have again formed a section by the name of banking and finance current affairs. The reason being here is because it consists of those news which are relevant only for the phase 1 examination from the bank and finance current affairs. And for phase 2, guys, we have a dedicated section of the GA plus finance current affairs in which we are preparing the finance current affairs that are relevant for phase 1 and phase 2. Along with that, all these current affairs are segregated as per your syllabus tag. If there is a news that is regarding the primary and secondary market, it has been shortened, it has been tagged, or it has been integrated under the subhead of primary and secondary market. And for the RBI notifications, guys, we have a proper separate document in which we are covering the RBI website for you. That is in by the notifications, that is in the RBI notification document that we are providing you in our course. So to download both these things, TKG, both the things are available in our course. So I hope, guys, you have liked this video. If you have liked the videos, kindly share the video with your friends also. And I hope you are clear that why even small bit of finance current affairs can play a very, very important role in the examination. Okay. So guys, if you have liked the video, kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel. And then to get the access of the PDF of this lecture as well as the other lectures that are available on YouTube, subscribe to the Telegram channel, the link for which is given in the description below. Still, guys, if you have any kind of doubt, you want to ask me, do not hesitate. Drop me an email at hello@arutab.co.in, or you could even have a call with me on the number that is 81462-07241, and I will be really, really glad to help you on the doubts that you have, even on this video or anything about current affairs. Do contact us on that. So wishing you all the best for the examination, guys. Bye-bye.